Later on C-SPAN, the House begins hearings on the 2011 budget. But first, earlier today, accused Times Square car bomber Faisal Shahzad held a press conference to address the charges against him.
Hello, my name is Nasrim Kardar. Mr. Shahzad has chosen to write his statement in his native language. I will translate with Ms. Ma. Good afternoon. My name is Faisal Shahzad, and I am here today because I can no longer remain silent about the injustices I have suffered and continue to suffer. Injustices at the hands of the United States government, which has unfairly accused me of crimes that I did not commit. And worse, injustices at the hands of the American news media, which has grossly invaded my privacy and lied about me at every turn. They have written embarrassing and inaccurate stories about my home foreclosure. They have pried into the breakup of my marriage. And most hurtful of all, they have continued to unfairly criticize the car bomb on which I worked so hard. And to describe it in the cruelest terms imaginable. Crude, primitive, third-rate, rudimentary, poorly constructed, unsophisticated, amateurish, unrefined, inexpert, unprofessional, obviously not well thought out, substandard, inept, unworkmanlike, bungling, half-assed, not even close to workable, low-end, the kind of device you'd find in the sale bin at a Mexican Kmart. Useless, ineffective, complete waste of time, an embarrassment, reminiscent of a first-grade science project. Cockamamie, Bush League, pathetic, risible, a word I had not seen before but which apparently means causing or being worthy of ridicule. An unmitigated disaster. Lame, like something from a Roadrunner cartoon. Slapdash, childlike. Since these press reports began 3 days ago, my sense of confidence and self-esteem has been completely shattered. I have difficulties sleeping. I have gained nearly 4 pounds. And I no longer find pleasure in activities I previously enjoyed, such as soccer and bomb making. And for those in the press who are so critical of my work, I have a question. What makes you so sure it was an explosive device? Maybe it was never intended to blow up. All right, fine, it was an explosive device. Happy now? But even so, some of the news commentary is simply uncalled for. Dimwit, palooka, stumblebum, buffoon, mechanical ignoramus. Don't quit your day job, which is particularly hurtful since I do not have a day job. Dolt, bird brain, obviously not 18. Ninny, meatball, the Fredo Corleone of the Taliban. Clown, numbskull.
We'll be leaving this press conference now and take you to the House hearings on the budget. The program runs about 2 hours.